shock collar.
One of those things.
No, I hope that was okay. I mean,
I
ran into that so many times. If you got somebody shooting to the side, you know where that student's gonna look.
Thank you.
straight off of your shoulder.
Thank you. tonight, Trinity College will be graduating students from the Bachelor of Science in Nursing program. We are here to recognize, acknowledge, and celebrate the achievement of these graduates. As many of you are aware, we are experiencing tremendous change within the American healthcare delivery system. And navigating the COVID-19 pandemic over the past 2 years has certainly added to this complexity. Amidst these changes and challenges are concerns of preparing healthcare professionals able to meet the needs of our nation's citizens. Our Trinity College graduates are entering the profession of nursing at a time when outstanding academic and clinical practice preparation are highly desired by employers. Soon to be graduates, you have been prepared well by the faculty within your chosen discipline, and we are extremely proud to call you a Trinity College graduate. As we begin our evening celebration, I would like to recognize our Trinity College governing board members who are here to celebrate the accomplishments of our graduates, Ms. Deborah Waymack and Mr. Bob Erickson. The governing board of Trinity College is a group of dedicated individuals who are committed to the mission and vision of the college. They provide the guidance needed to graduate such outstanding healthcare professionals for our community and beyond. Trinity College faculty provide a rigorous academic curriculum that prepares knowledgeable and proficient healthcare professionals who are educated to deliver culturally competent care to the patients they serve. Thank you to the faculty for instilling the college's core values of best practice, caring, diversity, integrity, and lifelong learning in each and every Trinity College graduate. To all of our Trinity College graduates, your dedication and hard work are undeniable. But I also know there are others who have sacrificed and supported you along your educational trajectory. For the spouses, partners, children, parents, grandparents, and friends, thank you for supporting your graduates through their strenuous journey. It has not been an easy journey, but it was a worthy journey, for these graduates are entering into a profession that is much needed and valued by our community, our country, and our world. I hope you enjoy this evening as we celebrate our Trinity College class of 2022. I ask that everyone please stand for the invocation offered by Dr. Melinda Goldenberg. Please remain standing following the invocation as we sing the Star Spangled Banner.
Please pray with me. God of all, we thank you for your presence here in this place, for this learning community of graduates, students, teachers, board members, and administrators, for this community of family and friends. Bless these graduates of tonight as they receive awards and degrees. Instill in them joy, happiness, and a sense of accomplishment. Bless these new nurses of tomorrow as they prepare to care for a world in need. Give their hearts compassion, their hands skill and tenderness, their minds knowledge and wisdom, and their souls courage. Give them voice to speak truth, thirst for new knowledge, and grace in all things. Send them out to bring healing, hope, and wholeness to those they care for and to those they care with. In your many names we pray. Amen.
Thank you. class of Trinity College of Nursing's Bachelor of Science in Nursing program. Some of us have completed the accelerated program in 15 months, that felt way longer, and are earning our second bachelor's degree tonight. Others enrolled in the more traditional route of a two-year program, but either way, tonight we celebrate our collective academic achievement as BSN graduates and can finally see a day off in our future. My BSNA cohort of 15 students includes those who are going back to school after successful careers in other fields. It's not a midlife crisis, I swear. And others who enrolled in the accelerated program immediately after graduating from their first undergraduate program. Last summer, we all met for the first time and spent full days of class together, studying for our weekly exams and learning how to be a nurse in our clinical rotations. Since then, we have become a close-knit group of people just trying to survive nursing school while maintaining some semblance of a personal life. Each and every one of us has overcome obstacles to be here today, and I don't think any of us could be more excited to finally be graduating and actually feeling prepared to sit for and hopefully pass the MCAS. As we celebrate our achievements tonight, it's imperative that we acknowledge the love.
Tonight, we will soon mark and identify you as successful graduates from a program that emphasizes the goals of knowledge, proficiency, and cultural care values. Using these goals to guide your next steps to excellence will serve you well in this rapidly changing healthcare environment. Consider the excellent knowledge and experience that you've gained on this educational pathway and the doors that are now opening for you. Your future success is not only your success, but also your family's success and Trinity College of Nursing and Health Sciences success. You are connected in we with you. This synergistic link is powerful and can propel you to great places. From all of us at Trinity College of Nursing and Health Sciences, I extend you my congratulations and best wishes to each of you. Thank you.
It is my pleasure to introduce this evening's commencement address speaker, Ms. Mary McCumber-Schmidt. Ms. McCumber-Schmidt holds a Bachelor of Arts degree in Criminal Justice from the University of Wisconsin-Platteville and a Master's of Criminal Justice and Business from St. Ambrose University. Ms. McCumber-Schmidt has 27 years of experience working in not-for-profit organizations, and she is currently the president of the Trinity Health Foundation. Ms. McCumber-Schmidt served Family Resources of the Quad Cities for 25 years prior to coming to Trinity. Ultimately, she became the president of this Quad Cities Community Resource. Ms. McCumber-Schmidt is the secretary for the Board of Directors of Every Child, formerly known as the Child Abuse Council. She also serves on the boards of the YWCA and Bettendorf Rotary. Ms. McCumber-Schmidt is an ardent supporter of Trinity College. Her work, with the efforts of her staff at the Trinity Health Foundation, have expanded the scholarships offered to Trinity College students. Please join me in welcoming my colleague and friend, Ms. Mary McCumber-Schmidt.
Thank you. And thank you for inviting me to be a part of such a special celebration today. It is as humbling as it is a bit frightening to find the perfect words to share with you on such a momentous occasion. While I was invited to share a few words, admittedly, I struggled. What could I offer such a prestigious occasion, and what do I have in common with the graduates before me? After some thought, it occurred to me, we share a united mission, a common goal, and a special calling to care for others. It just looks a bit different. Okay, maybe it looks very different, but our desire to care for our community is the same. As the president of Trinity's Health Foundation, it is my responsibility to lead a team whose mission is to connect the philanthropic generosity of our community with opportunities to support the highest level of healthcare in our community. As an example, many of you are recipients of foundation scholarships. Individuals and families with a passion to ensure a high-quality, robust, local healthcare workforce have helped to support you through charitable giving. Without a doubt, these donors are very proud of you today. They take great pride in your accomplishments and are grateful you have chosen a career in healthcare. Philanthropy is a calling to promote the welfare of others. The 17th century origin of the word philanthropy is love of mankind. Nursing has been described as both an art and a science, a heart and a mind. At its heart lies a fundamental respect for human dignity and an intuition for a patient's needs. The career, and quite honestly, the calling you have embraced with your accomplishments today are beyond ordinary. In fact, they are extraordinary. You have the skills to change the trajectory of the lives of patients entrusted to you. It is your care and compassion that creates gratitude, which in philanthropy we refer to as a grateful patient. So what is gratitude? Gratitude is a positive emotion and involves being thankful and appreciative. Gratitude stems from the recognition that something good happened to you, accompanied by recognizing that someone was responsible in some way for it. I imagine each of you are grateful for someone here today. I hope you are beaming with the highest level of gratitude for what you have accomplished and for those who have helped you along the way. If not already, I am confident that throughout your career, you will experience many patients and their families who are grateful for you. After a positive healthcare experience and exceptional care, many patients express gratitude to their care team. However, most care team members shy away from acknowledgement and receiving gratitude. When patients share their gratitude, a frequent response to say, "I was just doing my job." This is often the response we hear from nurses who are recognized for their superhuman care when receiving the National Daisy Award for Extraordinary Nurses. Please know your efforts go far beyond a job for a patient whose life you have changed. The way in which you accept gratitude is an important aspect of the relationship you aspire to build with patients. creating a positive experience for patients and families, includes the gracious acceptance of gratitude in three easy steps. First, listen to what patients or family members are saying beyond treatment protocol. Active listening engages all of your senses. Acknowledge their active listening, the emotions they are conveying to you. Accept gratitude graciously. Say thank you in your own unique way. William Arthur Ward said, feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. Accept these gifts that are offered to you. And lastly, reciprocate. Return the gratitude to the patient or family for allowing you to provide care. Not only will your gracious acceptance of gratitude build a stronger relationship, but did you know receiving and giving gratitude has significant impacts on physical and mental health? Some of the benefits of gratitude include higher self-esteem and higher levels of optimism. I have sat with many grateful patients many times and heard amazing stories of how nurses and other healthcare professionals have gone above and beyond expectations to care for patients, to save lives, and provide comfort during the most difficult times. It is a blessing to hear their stories. You and I each seek to ensure the best outcome for patients and the highest level of care for our community. It is the mission, the calling we have in common. In closing, I'd like to share with you one of my favorite grateful patient stories and hope it will inspire you and remind you how amazing and critical you are to your community and the countless lives you will touch. This is the story of a grateful family. Scott and Brian were brothers in their mid-20s. Brian was the oldest of four boys. They came from a hardworking family, and both dreamed of becoming the first in their family to graduate with a college degree. With a desire to serve his country and take advantage of the GI Bill, Brian had just returned home from the Navy. One evening, Scott and Brian were out together celebrating, with Scott at the wheel and Brian in the front passenger seat. They were less than 2 miles away from home when they veered off the road and wrapped their car around an electrical pole. Brian's body exited and returned to the passenger seat through the windshield of the car. With glass piercing his body, he was non-responsive to emergency personnel who came upon the scene of the accident. Gratefully, no one else was injured. Both Scott and Brian were rushed to Trinity Rock Island's emergency department. Scott was treated for minor injuries, but Brian was in critical condition. A family friend who worked at Trinity called to inform the boys' mother that their sons had been involved in a car accident. The words she will never forget were, "If you want to see Brian alive, you better get here quick." While Trinity's trauma team worked to save Brian's life, his brother could be heard pleading, "Where's my brother?" The family arrived, and over time, both boys made a full recovery. Many lessons were learned that night, and both boys graduated with college degrees and are now successful in their careers and raising their own families. Brian completed a degree in engineering and met the love of his life, whom he has been married to for 28 years. Together, they have raised two adult sons. If not for the heroic efforts of the nurses like you, doctors, technicians, and countless others, the outcome could have been much different. For Trinity's Rock Island Trauma Team, I am grateful. Although I did not meet Brian until months after the accident, this grateful patient story is our story. We are grateful for the care team who saved Brian's life. Without them, we would not have the life we enjoy today with our beloved sons, Jake and Sam. You are entering a career at a time when you are needed more than ever. Our healthcare systems are stretched beyond imagination. The impacts of the COVID pandemic have become tiresome to our dedicated heroes. There will be many days when exhaustion and stress will overwhelm you. Seize opportunities to recognize and accept the gratitude your patients express upon you. It will be beneficial to you and to them, and just might help you through that next exhausting day. On behalf of the countless patients you will meet throughout your career, from the bottom of our hearts, we are grateful for you. Thank you.
Good evening, fellow students, family, friends, and faculty. I would like to welcome and thank you once again for attending tonight's commencement in support of Trinity College of Nursing and Health Sciences, class of 2022. My name is Norman Moreno, and I will be giving the student address for the BSN class of 2022. I am incredibly honored to be given the opportunity to deliver the speech for this commencement ceremony. Tonight, Trinity College of Nursing and Health Sciences recognizes the prestigious accomplishments of graduates from both nursing programs. When given the task of writing the student address, I quickly discovered the difficulty in generalizing the experiences encompassing two programs that are seemingly different, yet the same degree. With that said, I would like to emphasize not what makes the graduating class of 2022 different, but what we collectively share as part of our journey. At the start of nursing school, we learned how to take vital signs, make patient beds, don on and off personal protective equipment, and how to transfer patients using safety equipment. Fast forward to today, we have had the great privilege to witness and assist in the delivery of the miracle of life in the labor and delivery unit. In the emergency department, we were able to collaborate to provide life-saving measures to stabilize patients experiencing a series of crises. In the operating room, we were able to monitor patients during operations and assist doctors throughout surgeries. In the intensive care unit, we were able to care for critically ill patients by immediately responding to changes in patients' conditions and identifying ongoing needs. I mention this not to minimize the importance of the activities we learned during our first weeks in school, but rather to emphasize the growth in our personal and professional development. The vast knowledge we have acquired, along with our clinical experiences, have molded us into becoming competent nurses and leaders for our families and our communities. However, if there is one thing everyone in this room can agree on, it is that nursing school is not easy. 2 years ago, my wife and I moved here without ever stepping foot in the Midwest. We adjusted to a life away from family and questioned our decision to live here after experiencing everyone's favorite season of the year, winter. For me, the Midwest winter serves as a great metaphor of what nursing school is like. Winter is long and causes you to slow down your hobbies, go out with friends less, and enter a state of hibernation. In our case, it was a state of continuous studying and learning while living through the societal implications of COVID-19 pandemic. The heavy snow weighs down hard and makes it difficult to plow forward. I relate such difficulty as experiencing by juggling several classes, clinicals, and countless assignments on top of family and work responsibilities. Almost like the winter that blows freezing and rapid winds with snow, causing you to temporarily lose sight of success in your future. It mimics the feeling after the neuro or endocrine exams, the comprehensive predictor, or even those daily quizzes we all look forward to. Despite the hardships winter brings, all hardships experience serve a critical purpose. On a large scale, seasonal snow helps regulate temperature of the Earth's surface, and eventually the snow melts, causing plants and animals to be nourished, and helping rivers and reservoirs fill with water. Soon, spring and summer are back healthier than ever, bringing families outdoors for fun and play. Our summer is here, a new beginning, not as students, but as soon-to-be healthcare professionals. The challenges we endure help prepare us for this moment and for a future that will help change the world into a better place, one patient at a time. We should remember this journey to be a lesson of resilience, grit, and tenacity. Above all, we should continue to cultivate a spirit of inquiry, one that will persist to enhance our knowledge and skills while serving as role models, not just in the healthcare profession with our patients, but everyday humans with our friends and loved ones. I would now like to recognize those who played a crucial role in helping this accomplishment become a reality. I would like all to take a moment to think of these influential people in your lives. For me, these people include my professor, Terry Helder, who went above and beyond providing extraordinary support and being such a compassionate and reliable mentor. I would like to thank my family and friends for all their love and support, my wife, my partner for life, and the person I call start of our new careers is the start of a new adventure. I hope you all continue to follow and embrace your passions while trusting your instincts. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors, and remember that nothing worth having comes easy. Class of 2022, we did it. Thank you.
Kylie Faith Ackerman. Shanaya Asalome. Brianna Renee Bateman. Erica Mark. Lainey K. Bigler, Sigma. Lenore Louise Benton Bay. Janina Buckingham. Abigail Brianna Bush. Lauren Christensen. Caitlin Marie Conway. Hannah Crokert. Ellen Zinn Berenberg. Carissa Kimberly Ferry. Mike Fisher, valedictorian, Sigma. Daisy Gonzalez, Sigma. Thomas Graham. Brooke Nicole Griswold, Sigma. Kelly Hancock, Sigma, Student Government Association.
Yeah, Kelly.
Skylar Rain Cowlett. Dominic Hudley. Jenny Allison O'Connor.
Sigma.
Allie Lefebvre. Shannon Marie Lennon. Quentin Mayer.
He's so hot.
Catherine Marie Maloney.
You got that. Oh, okay.
Bailey Mathias, Sigma. Olivia Isabel Mendoza. Hannah Myers. Norman Moreno. Christian Valley. Tucker Ward.
Good job, Tucker!
Allison Wheeler.
Woo!
Sarah Marie Wilson.
Class of 2022, this is the moment you have been waiting for.
change your tassels. Congratulations, graduates.
Recognizing that life is a precious gift. Although I am a nurse, I didn't always see myself as one. 30 years ago, if you would have asked me why I wanted to be a nurse, I may have said that it was because my family suggested that it might be a good career path for me. What I learned during my time as a student at Trinity College of Nursing, and I was a student not just once, but 3 times for my diploma, then for my BSN completion, and then to go on for my MSN, was that we're all on a journey, one of collaborative, reciprocal learning, full of self-discovery. What I didn't know then, but know now, is that my family, who knew me better than anyone else, could see qualities in the young me that would pair well with those needed to be successful and find fulfillment in this unique career path. What else did I learn? To listen to my mom. For in this case, she was right. 30 years ago, my dream job was to be working in the nursery. I recall being a nursing student. I remember this day clearly, walking past the nursery windows. You guys seen the movie Steel Magnolias with Julia Roberts, and she's working in the nursery? So that was kind of the day where the babies were in the nursery. And I walked past those nursery windows, and I just was full of wonder, wondering, how did those nurses get that job? How would I possibly be lucky enough to get hired into that department? And did I even have what it took to be successful in that career? Would I even have the opportunity to have that career? And honestly, just like that, I landed that dream job. 20 years ago, my dream was to complete my BSN and to take on a leadership position within the maternal child care area of clinical practice. And seemingly, just like that, I completed that degree at Trinity College, and I got that promotion that I'd worked so very hard for. 10 years ago, my dream was to complete my MSN and transition into a faculty role at Trinity College so that I could give back to the profession that had given me so much pride and satisfaction over the years. And just like that, I completed my degree and now have the extraordinary pleasure of working with students who remind me that learning is reciprocal and ongoing. What I did really truly learn from my time spent at Trinity College, and continue to daily, was to listen, ask questions, take every opportunity, challenge myself, be accountable, and to value collaboration. These important lessons have carried me through and helped me to achieve my goals. So, did it really happen just like that? No, of course it didn't. As anything worth being proud of, takes effort, and it takes time to achieve. As I thoughtfully reflect back on what it took to make it all happen, it comes down to hard work, small sacrifices, sometimes difficult choice, often those were financial, a steadfast dedication, a little creativity, and most importantly, the ongoing support of friends, family members, peers, colleagues, faculty members, and mentors who invested their time and energy into my development. My wish for each of you graduates of the department is that you reflect on what you've learned over the last 15 months to 2 years, and consider how your experiences will help you to achieve your goals. How has your exposure to new information and ideas, clinical challenges, and the culture of healthcare changed your perspective? What have your aha moments been that have validated and confirmed for you that you're on the right path? Who has supported you, and how will you pay it forward? What is your dream job, and how might that dream evolve over time? If you have learned anything over the last 2 years, it's been to be flexible and ready to face challenges that come your way. You did not make it to this point by accident or just like that, but rather, through your hard work, dedication, and steadfast commitment to your educational goals. As the future of healthcare continues to be shaped by current events and your career path may take some expected twists and turns, the healthcare job market is hot, offering new graduates the chance to embark on job opportunities that promise to provide career momentum and growth. One thing is for sure, whatever path you choose, the Alumni Association will be alongside you for every step of the way as you grow professionally. Whether you're looking for a mentor in your chosen profession, looking to continue education, or looking to maintain the close relationships that you've established with your classmates, turn to your Alumni Association. The association is as great as the individual members, so stay involved and make a difference in healthcare and in your Alumni Association. Welcome to you all and congratulations.
Good evening, family, friends, professors, faculty, and staff, indeed, the graduating class of 2022. My name is Lisa Marie Carrero, and I'm honored to be speaking tonight as a graduate from the Bachelor's of Science in Nursing. Tonight, we are here to celebrate our accomplishments and the beginning of our nursing careers. To our family and friends near and far, thank you for supporting us on our journey. Thank you for taking the time to listen when we were stressed and overwhelmed. Thank you for hearing us geek out about what we learned in class or what we experienced during clinical. Thank you for the encouragement on days we really needed it most. To the nurses we were able to shadow throughout clinical and have as preceptors, you have helped us build confidence in our knowledge and abilities to be wonderful nurses. You have provided us opportunities to practice skills as well as take time to explain concepts so we can learn to think critically. Working in healthcare can be scary and intimidating, but you have showed us that, you have showed us how extraordinary nursing can be. To our professors, faculty, and staff, thank you for helping us navigate being a student in nursing school. You have spent countless hours teaching us content and concepts so we can learn to critically think. You have provided us guidance and encouragement so we could stay on track to finish the program. You have taken time outside of the classroom to help us understand the material we were learning, which guided us being able to walk across the stage today. You have also been supportive of us outside of the classroom and were a listening ear when we really needed it. And for all of that, to the class of 2022, we did it. We've completed all of our clinical hours and were able to practice in a variety of different settings. We've made it through the late nights and early mornings of studying. We have also made it through all the technological difficulties over these couple of years. So special thanks to Maddles. One thing I admire about this class is our resilience. We started the program during a pandemic and were flexible with the frequently changing conditions of the hospital. Some of you are parents and had to balance not only school, but work, your families, and I'm sure a variety of other things. Throughout our journey in nursing school, we learned a lot about ourselves, what specialties we're interested in, and what kind of nurses we want to be. There There's no doubt in my mind that we can accomplish all we have been thinking about working towards these past 2 years. As our journey in nursing school comes to an end, the beginning of our careers as nurses await. For those who plan on continuing their education, I wish you the best of luck. This is a new chapter for many of us that we are about to embark on. And over the years, I've been told, if you do what you love, you'll never have to work a day in your life. So while working in healthcare has proven to be challenging, I hope you all are doing what you love. Thank you very much, everyone. Congratulations to the class of 2019.
Thank you.
black people. Yeah.
First three, and now this.